Hello everyone and welcome to my channel and welcome to class 6. I appreciate you all attending right from 1 to class 6, and those of you are watching me for the first time, I highly recommend go back to my earlier videos where you will get a proper idea of what is going on for today's class. What we did for class 1 was parts of our abacus. We did style up with abacus. Then class 2 we did the values, okay? Then class 3 also we learned higher values 6, 7, 8, 9. Then we did the basic movements of 1 to 4 and we did addition subtraction 1 to 4. So today we are going to be doing basic movements 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Now if you want to practice more, if you want to know how to use it in your school curriculum, we are having a master class. So I highly recommend you will join the master class so you will get a better idea of how to use the tool abacus, how to use the concept in your school curriculum. Okay, the link will be shared in the description box and click on it and join for the master class. So now to begin with class 6, let us first learn the basic movements of 5. I think we did 5, but I'll just go through it once again. 6, 7, 8 and 9. So basic movements, what do they do? Why they are useful? Because they help us in adding and subtracting. Just using the basic movements, it makes our work much easier. We just remember the basic movement, we do addition and we do subtraction. So as I said, 5 is on top. So plus 5 and minus 5, there are two basic movements. One is plus 5, second is minus 5. Okay, plus and minus. Plus 5, the top 5 rupee coin or the top bead, you can say, move down by index. And minus 5, top bead move up by index. Okay, so for 5, as I said, we only use the index finger. For the other numbers, we use our thumb and index. But for 5, only the index finger. Move down and move up. Now, for number 6. Okay, plus 6 and minus 6. First of all, you need to know how to get the value 6. So, for 6, 5 and 1 joined together. See how I am using? My index finger is on 5. My thumb is on this lower bead. Okay, so minus 6 is split together. Plus 6 is they both join together. 5 and 1 join together. Minus 6, 5 and 1 splits together. Okay, so the top bead is like a 5 rupee coin and the lower beads are like our 1 rupee coins. So plus 6 and minus 6. 7 plus 7 minus 7. 5 and 2 beads. This gives me plus 7. 5 and 2 beads when they go away gives me minus 7. Once again, plus 7 is 5 and 2, minus 7 is 5 and 2 go away from each other. Next is plus 8 and minus 8. Plus 8, 5 and 3 come together. Minus 8, 5 and 3 go away from each other. Plus 8, 5 and 3 come together. Minus 8, 5 and 3 go away from each other. Plus 9 and minus 9. These are the easiest ones. The 9 is the easiest one. 5 and all 4 beads join together. Minus 9, 5 and all 4 beads go away from each other. And as I said, when nothing is touching, the value is 0. So let us again run through the basic movements. And because the basic movements, we are going to be learning how to add and subtract higher numbers 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So plus 5, minus 5, where we use only the index finger. Plus 6, minus 6, where we use the index and the thumb, and minus 6. Plus 7, again we use the index and the thumb. 5 and 2. And for 8, 5 and 3. Okay. And minus 8, 5 and 3 go away. Plus 9, 5 and 4. And minus 9, 5 and 4 go away from each other. So these are the basic movements 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 which we need to learn and we need to get thorough so that we learn how to add and subtract for our next class. And don't forget, if you want to practice more, if you want to use it in your school curriculum, do join our master class. The link will be shared in the description box. Thank you for attending and bye.